You already had breakfast?
You. I want PPJ.
It's breakfast time, so you get cereal.
No. I want PPJ.
Liam's having bread. Liam has been obsessed with bread lately. He keeps taking it. Good morning, by the way, guys. It's Friday, which means I've almost survived the first week of Lonnie back at work. Sit down and eat. Thank you for letting me put your hair in a man bun.
Wrapped around your arms instead of being lonely.
You play with Dad?
It's not the stars, but now it feels just like I wandered off into a room and closed the door behind me.
She's starting to come up to us so much more now.
Even though I wanna
take She loves Sophia the First, right?
I should be trying something.
Okay, so speech will be here in like 30 minutes. They wanted to overlap with ABA. Today's video is about Liam restarting ABA. I will talk about this like I always do for those who are a little bit confused. I'm gonna talk about it. I asked some questions on Instagram. I'll answer them at the end, but this is his third day of ABA. It started this week. And so speech wanted to be here when ABA was here so we can make sure that everyone's on the same page, because communication is probably the biggest part of ABA therapy and one of the reasons that really pushed us to want to have them be a part of our team for Liam. I'm gonna be putting on my makeup so I can look like a person. Very important. So, hi guys.
Nellie, what's going on with you? You wanna brush your teeth?
I'm tired of dwelling in the dark. It's just that my heart can't take it. I didn't know what it would cost me when I let you go. I feel alone and I'm just singing.
It's Friday, so that means Del Taco. Lonnie, do you want some Del Taco? I mean, you are tall. All right, I will grab you some tacos. So, exciting news on the ABA therapy. They found a second RBT for Liam. So currently he's at 8 hours a week. He's approved for up to 40. So we are trying to staff him, but we're trying to staff him slowly so we don't overwhelm the poor boy. Oh, and at the end of the video, I'm going to answer all your questions from Instagram. So stay tuned for that. I like doing the Q&As at the end because I figure it covers a lot of questions, because sometimes I don't talk about things because I don't realize it's something that you guys are wondering or you're confused about or you want clarification. And we are all about educating, especially when it comes to autism and special needs. So we are going to get going. I'm so glad it's Friday, guys. So glad it's Friday.
A few moments later.
Right, let's go home. Are you watching Mario? He loves him some Mario. I'm sure he's gonna love the show. So his therapist is about to be here, so I'm gonna try eating really quick.
No.
Many minutes later.
So I took a nap. I feel better. So Lonnie and I are gonna run to the store just to grab a few things for the weekend. The weekend we're basically both just doing different things, like we're getting the house together, and tomorrow
I asked for it.
Good job. Look how cute his hair looks. Are you gonna be a YouTuber when you get older?
Yeah.
Can I kiss?
Finger kiss.
Tomorrow I am going to be doing Danielle's hair in passion twists. It's the weekend. I survived the first week of Lonnie going back to work, and I was hoping I was going to be here on Friday and be like, it wasn't as bad as I thought. Like, I just kind of freaked myself out. That's not what happened. It was a pretty rough transition. The first 2 days were the worst, but I think just kind of like having the house be completely ready Monday morning to have therapies. I think that's going to relieve so much stress off of me, because that was the most stressful part, was trying to manage 6 kids, feeding, laundry, baths, getting them dressed, tons and tons of therapies, and then also having 2 channels at the same time was just a lot on top of cleaning, like deep cleaning things. I think I've already kind of talked about it, but Liam was approved for ABA therapy for 40 hours. I might, hang on, honey, do you wanna go ahead and go? I can explain this in the car. So, backstory, let's rewind a little bit for our newbies. So Liam was diagnosed with autism when he was about 18 months old. Around 19 to 20 months old, I went ahead and put him in ABA therapy. It was just what I thought was appropriate. I was a new autism mama. I know that sounds strange because I have a 13-year-old son with autism, but I didn't have to make a lot of the therapy choices with Noah that I had to make with the little ones, and it seemed like it was what I needed to do. It was what everyone was telling me was the right thing to do. So I enrolled him in ABA therapy. A couple months went by. I noticed he wasn't his happy self. If you know Liam, Liam's just a happy go lucky boy, and he's happy about everything. And then when he had breaks from ABA, he would start progressing again, because during it he was regressing. But Liam's always been like a progressing, regressing kind of kid too. Liam was so young and I wasn't able to really see what was his baseline. Was he a kid that naturally regressed a lot, or was this something else? So I made the choice to go ahead and stop ABA therapy after like 2-ish months. That was that. I have no regrets at all. I firmly believe that there wasn't a reason for him to be in it. There really wasn't behaviors. I didn't agree with the tactics that ABA company was using. I had to learn how to advocate for my child and be like, no, I don't like that. I was very open with the fact that it did not mean that my kids would never go in ABA therapy. That we weren't against ABA therapy. We were just against it for Liam at that age. I stand behind that. All right, Lonnie ran into the store, so I figured I could go ahead and finish everything. When we moved here, I did a lot of heavy research, into different companies. And I really like this company, but even still, our first experience with ABA, as I told you, was not the best. It wasn't the worst. It wasn't like a horror story or anything like that. I just didn't like their methods. Like, they were basically trying to enforce eye contact. They were trying to enforce Liam to point, but not in a functional sense. And so I really didn't like that. I went into this company kind of with an open, cautious mind. Lex, our 4-year-old, and Noah was 12 at the time when he started. And I remember when I talked to the BCBA, they told me that she was like one of the best in the company. And she is, like, she definitely is. I was just honest with her. I was like, in our house, we think autism is a good thing. We think it's a positive thing. We are not wanting to train the autism out of them. We aren't wanting to stop sense. We aren't wanting to force eye contact. I was like, I don't want to change who they are as a person. I just want to give them the tools that they can be the best independent version of themselves as possible. She later shared with me that actually warmed her heart a lot, because, you know, not every parent feels that way. She feels the same. The company we go with actually has their BCBAs go through no trauma like programs for ABA therapy. What that means is it's a program so they can have the latest of the latest. Like, there's studies out there that show that kids really don't have to look you in the eye to pay attention or engage. That it's possible to do therapy with a kid that doesn't have eye contact. That stopping stims is harmful. The whole point of it is to stop ABA therapy from being a traumatic event. It shouldn't be. It should be there to help you. And I will tell you that everything our company does, that's what OT does and speech does and physical therapy. She's been our BCBA for 5 months now. Like, we got in contact like right after we moved here, and she's just been amazing with the kids. And I knew pretty early on that we were going to go ahead and put Liam into ABA therapy, but I said I was gonna wait till his 3rd birthday. Well, like a month or two after we had gotten here, he started to get really, really frustrated. He started to have a lot of behaviors. He started to progress in areas of development. That was wonderful, right? But it made other things harder. Like, he started climbing on tabletops, and he learned to undo doorknobs, and he learned how to pull out dresser drawers and climb on them. And so all of these things created safety issues, and then him not being able to communicate just got worse and worse and worse. It made him get very, very frustrated about the smallest things. He was constantly just having issues all day long. It was like he'd be upset about something, but we didn't know what he was upset about. It's just been a really hard battle with him in communication, and that is why I'm so excited that Penelope has been picking up sign language so easily. The battle we have had with Liam and communication is hard. We started trying to do sign language with Liam around 14 months old. He's always just refused to do it. It's like if we try to sign to him, he just shuts down. Like, he looks the other way or he starts screaming at us. I don't think he gets the concept, or maybe he does get the concept and he's just not down with it. And I'm not sharing these because I feel like I need to justify our choice. This is the best choice for Liam. It's in home. I'm there constantly. It's literally gonna be in the area I'm in all day long. Obviously, I'm going to advocate for him in the best way possible. And we have an amazing team for Liam. So I'm not doing this because I feel like I need to explain ourselves. I'm telling you guys this because I want to help, I don't know, educate, inform. I don't feel like educate's the right word. I don't feel like I'm like qualified to educate people, but maybe inform people. We will be working on is safety behaviors, sensory seeking. What that means is for Liam to start recognizing that he needs different forms of sensory input or output. The biggest piece of it is communication. That's why speech is working so hand in hand with ABA. So speech is currently trialing Liam for an AAC device. And that's just one of those like tablet communication devices. But the trial period takes a while. Like, it'll probably be 3 or 4 weeks before we have the trial device. And then after that, he has to be using it for 6 weeks. It has to show that he's like down with it, he's understanding it, and then from that point it can take months. So until the trial device is here, we didn't want to just do nothing with him, so we are still continuing PECs. ABA is working with speech, and what we're doing is we're kind of modifying PECs. Like, usually with PECs, which is picture exchange communication system, it's basically like if Liam wants bread, he finds a picture card that says bread, brings it to me, I give him bread. That's the PEC system. What he will be doing is they'll be teaching him to just touch it, because that's how the tablet will be. So that way we aren't having to teach him a completely different concept, because when speech comes, she brings us her iPad with the software downloaded on it, and he just touches it. I really couldn't think of anything else that I really want to work on with Liam. I just want him to not climb on tabletops because he's jumping off. And guys, I mean, he's got no like situational awareness. So sometimes when he's jumping, there's things on the floor that could hurt him if he fell and hit his head. Obviously, a two-year-old climbing on a table, it's a very typical thing. Like, I feel like Lonnie Jr. did that. But at the same time, we want to kind of hone in on that. Right now, they are just establishing a relationship and they are figuring out what motivates him the most. So he started 8 hours this week. He'll be like that for a little bit. And then they found a 9 to 2 person for Monday and Tuesday. But she won't start for a couple of weeks just because we have Nelly's surgery next week. And then I wanted to give him some time to adjust. I am watching him very, very, very carefully. Obviously, I'm very nervous about it with him. And so I want to watch him and make sure that all the methods that are being used are good ones. I did ask some questions on Instagram, like always, just to kind of get me an idea of what you guys were wondering, so I didn't have to do like a second video. Cass Ventures asked why we're doing ABA. They had a bad experience with it. I'm not gonna read the whole message because it's a little bit personal. And I understand and I respect, there are autistic individuals out there that have went through ABA and it has given them trauma, and I'm respectful of that. That is your story. I'm not here to tell you any different. I'm not here to tell you that you had the wrong kind or you didn't go through that or is different than what you experienced, because what you experienced is what you experience, and I'm so sorry that that happened to you. All I can say for me is it's been life-changing for Lex and Noah. They both love ABA very, very much. We have cameras everywhere. I've witnessed it firsthand. I've witnessed it when they don't know when I'm in the room. I feel like ABA therapy is a really general term for this therapy that almost anyone can start a business and say that they use it. It really depends on the company, the BCBA, the RBTs. Like, it's different across the board, and so it's really hard to compare. Like, every company's gonna have different methods that they're okay with using. It's not one size fits all, but that doesn't take away from the fact that people have went through it and it's been traumatizing to them, and I am so sorry, because I feel like it's a thing that can be a wonderful tool, a wonderful resource, a wonderful therapy if executed correctly. So I hope that answered your question. Kaden asks, how is this time different than the last time, and why did you decide to start again? I already talked about why I decided to start again. The difference between this time and last time is age. I mean, it's been over a year. He's a lot older now. He's gonna be 3 at the beginning of January. He's also presenting with behaviors that I feel like they can specifically help with. I feel like before there wasn't a lot to help Liam with because Liam didn't do a lot. So they were like, well, he doesn't point and he doesn't do eye contact. Let's work with that. Just Me Taylor asked, does Liam like therapies? Yes, Liam loves therapies. When his therapists walk in, he just runs up to them. Some of these questions are like, how is it going? And guys, I'm not even going to pretend to be like, oh, it's going well, because it's the first week. Like, of course it's going well. It's the first week. I mean, I guess it's a good sign he didn't like throw any tantrums. But I will say that his RBT walked in the house this morning and he immediately recognized her and he ran up to her. That was a really good sign because he hadn't done that the other 2 days. She's a really good RBT. She's worked hand in hand with the BCBA for the boys, and she said she's just amazing. ABA is Applied Behavioral Analysis Therapy, and if everyone's wondering why it has such controversy, it's been around for a while, and unfortunately, ABA decades ago, and sometimes even today, a lot of people want to refer to traumatizing therapy as something that's like in the past and it doesn't happen anymore, and it happens. It happens with occupational therapy, physical therapy, speech therapy, behavioral therapy. It can happen with any therapy, and it's not some old school notion that a therapist could execute something not in the benefit of a child and their development, and then it causes traumatizing effects. Mama Money Money asks, what is this program's approach? Do they allow stimming? The program's approach at this point is just to get him communicating with us and really working on those skills to get him to engage. He's been doing really good with engagement, so I'm sure he's just going to soar with this. They do allow stimming, and I've always been very, very open from the get-go that, hey, we don't stop stimming. Not once have they ever, ever tried to redirect stimming, stop stimming, say something about their stimming. In fact, when Noah has conversations with them about it, because he'll bring it up sometimes, and they are always positive and be like, yeah, but that makes you you. Like, that's part of who you are, and that makes you feel better.
A lot of times that's at a request of a parent anyway.
Not always. Every company is different.
Communication.
Yeah.
As far as, like, our ABA therapist, they ask us, hey, what do you feel comfortable with?
Anytime they do something or something comes up that they're unsure of, they always come and ask us. If they don't know how we want to explain to, like, Noah, it's usually Noah on these things, they'll come to us and be like, how do you want to proceed with this? We are a part of the program, the decision-making skills, the goals, every step of the way. They're trying to find objects and things that Liam enjoys and loves, so that way they can work on having him touch it, and that's just an important part, and they're doing exactly what speech would do. So they are following speech's guide on this. G. Ellen asks, how's Liam's behavior in ABA? Any aggression? Bo can get quite aggressive. So Liam does have a little bit of aggression that's starting up, like he's starting to hit and things like that and get frustrated, but his aggression isn't really significant, and we are addressing it now while it's coming up instead of waiting until it's reached a point that it reached with, like, Lex and Noah. We of course don't want to wait that long. Mr. Thajay 8N asked, with Lonnie back to work, will you get another vehicle? No. So we have not had a second vehicle in a really long time, like probably like 10 years. And Lonnie's always worked, or I've worked, and we just make it work. Lonnie is working from home, so there's really no reason to get a second vehicle. Will we get one in the future? Probably. Lonnie would like a truck, but that is like a far off notion. ALX asks, is eye contact a goal of his? No. Eye contact is not, pointing is not. All of his goals are communication goals or safety goals. Just kind of learning how to functionally play and have more joint attention when playing. So being able to include others in playing, but those are all like bottom goals. All of his main goals are communication and safety. Tia Shimito asked, does Liam has or had any feeding issues in the past or present? No. He's had the issue, well, he'll eat everything, even non-food items, but he's never been a picky eater, like ever. He eats everything. They also asked if Liam's starting to point out things, and yes, he's actually starting to functional point, and he did that on his own. So that's why I'm not really forcing these things. A lot of times kids are just going to do it on his own. He just saw an airplane one day when I pointed. He just happened to look point, which he's never done, and ever since then now he'll, if he sees something he likes in like the sky or something like that, he'll be like, look, look, and he'll point to it. They also asked, do you think you could compare Liam versus Noah at this age, who is more autistic? I don't think there's a thing as more autistic, and I'm just going to be frank with you because, again, we're about informing on this channel. That's offensive. Not to me, but like, it could be offensive to Liam, it could be offensive to Noah, it could be offensive to other autistic individuals. The correct way to say it is, do you think that Liam needs more support at this age than Noah did? Other than language, Noah was further along in language at this point, but other than that, they were probably about the same as the support that they would need. Eximari3 asked, do you really believe it will help? I do, and because I currently have two kids that are already in ABA, they've been in ABA for 4 to 5 months now. No, I need the sunlight. The sun's going down. It's helped them immensely. I really think this attributes to the fact that we went with an ABA company that is like positive autism. Also, that works with all the other therapies. So it isn't like we're having contradicting information between ABA and OTPT speech, and it's just confusing, and I don't know which is the right way to go. I had that problem in Florida. They're all on board. They literally ask each other, how can I support you? Like, it's really amazing to see they share information with each other and kind of come up with a game plan together.
Taste this and tell me what it tastes like. You're not going to be disappointed.
It's a mystery flavor. It tastes like...
Don't tell them, it's a mystery. They gotta find out for themselves.
What is it? E.L. Fudge asked, what are short-term goals with Liam and ABA, like next 6 months? For us, it's more about him just be able to effectively use his pecs. I think it was like 6 items that he could point out, 6 items. Everything else is more longer-term goals because, as I said, communication is probably the biggest aspect. You always want to find out why your child's frustrated instead of trying to fix their frustration, if that makes sense. So for Liam, us trying to fix his frustration but not trying to help him communicate wouldn't be helpful. It would be helpful for us to help him communicate, as that's going to lessen his frustration. So this girl, L. Gracie, she asked, why is Liam so cute? He must get it from his sister. All right, guys, that is it. I hope this answered all of your questions. Today is Friday night, which means I'm having a special kind of stream on Friday nights on You Now. We do guesting, which is video chat, so you get to come on in front of everyone in the chat and video chat with me, and we just talk and have a good time, and we also have grown-up drinks. It is known as our drinking stream. It started when Corona started, and I was like, oh, it's just a nice way to kind of socialize with everyone and kind of just connect, since we couldn't like go out and do things, and it just kind of stuck. Now we just do it and it's fun. If you ever want to hang out with us, it's usually around 8:30 Eastern on Friday nights, and I stream for hours and hours and hours, and we just have a great time. So I'm really excited. After the week I've had, guys, I deserve some drinky drinks, okay? Thank you guys for following along. I know that ABA therapy is so touchy, it's controversial. I get that. And that's why sometimes I feel a little bit like eggshelling, because I feel like if I talk about it in a positive light, I'm dismissing everyone that's had issues with it in the past and anyone that's in therapy because of it. And that's not my intentions. And I want to say this, it's not a right fit for every single child. And that is why I'm watching Liam so carefully, because I'm like, he might just be a kid that doesn't prosper. I definitely think it's worth a try, since these companies' tactics, the BCBA, all of them kind of align with what we feel. If you're a new autism mama and you're just unsure, go with your gut. My gut at the time was telling me it just wasn't time. Noah has never had any ABA therapy before now. Is that something that I wish I could go back in time and change? Of course, I will tell you, a bad company is way worse than no company. It's better to just go without the therapy than going with a therapy that's not going to have your child's best interests at mind. Don't feel like you have to do ABA therapy. You do not. Just because it worked for Sally down the road doesn't mean it's gonna work for you, right? I love you all. And I'm going to go have a fun night. So we will see you guys on Tuesday.
Where you move, make me blind. You will always be there. There's no doubt in my mind. You will always be there.